Now that is just one of the channels for the bearings to ride up and down that carry the platform for the elevator. It's just 12 feet. That's all it needs to be. It sits against the wall. Bearings go in here inside of it. Should work good. Well, I learned one thing. I did roughly 4 feet, two sides, of that with dry cutting discs. These things. These are the zip ones. They're really, really thin. They're not 1/8. They're less than that. About a 32nd of an inch thick. Somewhere around there. You get 20 of them for $10. If you watch regularly, 35, but they come on sale all the time for $9.99. So I used quite a few of them. About 3/4 of a package, but here's what I learned. I used 8 discs to go 4 feet. I used 4 discs once I put the water to it with the hose. I used 4 discs. No, excuse me. I used 6 discs to do the remainder, which would be 8 feet. So I used 6 discs to do 8 feet. It's 3/16 thick. And I used 8 discs to do just 4 feet. It gives you an idea of the water makes a huge difference. Huge difference in making your wheels last longer, and it cuts better too. Much better. Well, we'll go on to the next one tomorrow. Well, there's the rack. I got the other channel cut. I don't know if you can see that or not. There's a channel all the way, both sides, for the bearing to run in. And got it square. Got it straight. And got it welded together. So that's ready. Now we got to work on framing the opening in the floor before we install this. Now here we are 3 hours later, and the frame for the elevator shaft hole through the floor is finished. It fits. It's all pre-drilled. Weld it up, ready to be installed. And after this install, then I can take the track in and stand it up and start working on that.